Hello, it's Sarah, and I think I'm ready. I have a lot of stuff here in front of me. I've been crocheting and I've been trying to gather up some shabby chic supplies and things to make some shabby chic projects with. I still need flower centers. I don't have a lot of, like I'm going to show you my flowers in a minute, but I really have very little, so I need some input where to get that. But let me just show you what I've been doing. So I've been crocheting. I had to brush up on my crochet a little bit, so I started out with big yarn. And I was very inspired by KimmyB09. And if you guys haven't seen her work, it's lovely. She also does a lot of shabby chic stuff, so that's what caught my eye. But in particular, there's one video that she has called My Crocheted Creations, where she's done flowers, and they're tiny little flowers, like they're at least the size of a quarter. And as you'll see, most of mine, the biggest I have is like, I mean the smallest I should say, it's like 1 3/4 inches big, but I'll show you in a sec. So I started out big. The thing about Kimmy B, though, is she doesn't have any tutorials or anything. I mean, that I noticed. There were quite a few, actually, on YouTube, and I tried quite a few of them, and I'm not going to go into all of them, but Tutu Amy had some very sweet, quick, cute beginner pieces. I didn't try the butterfly yet, and I meant to, but I was doing flowers tonight. I just did these other little flowers that I found online, actually. So there are a lot of sources out there if you want to learn to crochet or do flowers. There's tons of videos on YouTube and on everywhere. So I'll just show you what I did. Now, this is called a motif. This one is one that I got on YouTube, and they call it a motif. And evidently, motifs are, you know, it's just a like it turns into a thing. Like it's done. Like this is a motif. What else was a motif? Now this was considered a doily. Let me see. So I did that in a couple colors. And this is like a soft yarn, kind of like a baby yarn probably. And this is just a real thick yarn. So you can see the difference in size a little bit. It's definitely got a different texture, different feel to it. But I love it. It's pretty. And to make a doily in that motif, I thought would be pretty. So this is done with like thread. It's called, I have it right here. And you get really tiny crochet needles, but it's like a thread. I have to find my floss too, because I do have floss from when I did plastic canvas, and I don't know. I've done different stitching projects over the years, but this was the smallest of all that I've ever tried, and so that's what this is made out of. So this was really doily, like I thought. So there's one of those on one of my flowers. I'll show you in a minute. So then I found this other flower design, and I really like the shape. They're not perfect. Obviously, I was just brushing up, and as you change crochet hook sizes and change yarn sizes, you know, you get a difference in the flower size as well. And then some of them I wasn't paying attention. Now, this is actually different. They're two different flowers. You can tell from the middle. But they're both 5 petals. No, this is a 6 petal. This is a 5 petal. So I did a 6 and a 5. So this is a 6, 6. But then the ones I was working on today were the smallest, and I found these online. And these are pretty cute. They're a good size for projects, I think. And they're a little rough looking. I think I need a little more practice with the smaller yarn and the smaller projects. Obviously, you have to be a little more intricate with it and stuff. So, and I'm watching TV when I do this, so I'm probably not paying attention. But I like this motif. I don't know if that's what you would call it. I like the ring around the center. And you know what this was actually for? She put it on a hat for like a baby. She stitched the button onto the hat, and then you could button this onto the hat and change the color of the flower on the hat by buttoning it onto the hat over the button, and then the button becomes the center. So that was really cute. I googled beginner flowers, beginner doilies, things like that. And that's what I came up with. This was one I just did tonight, and I really like the shape of this and the design. It's not perfect, and it was really confusing, but I did finish it, and it didn't look half bad. So that's another one I tried tonight. So those are my crocheted pieces, and I just want to bring in now some shabby chic flowers that I made. I did these yesterday, and there's quite a few of the tutorials out there. And I should have looked beforehand, but I don't remember her name, but it was a really great tutorial. She showed how she folds the fabric. You cut the fabric into squares and then you fold it. And I don't have any here. Well, I do. It's over there, though. I had to take a minute to get it. But just Google it. I mean, I'm not Google it. You know, put it in the search bar of YouTube, Shabby Chic Flowers, and they come up. So I just grabbed, I still have some of my materials out from when I made my thread books. So I grabbed what I had. This gold fabric was from a pillow that I took apart from Goodwill. That's one of my doilies. And then there's just a metal piece and a pearl in the middle. But it's a little big. I think I want to try and go smaller. I'm trying to embellish. I mean, this could be the focal point on a box or something. So, I mean, it's not. I'm going to keep it and we'll see what happens. But I love how the doily looks. I did start to tone them down by the end. This is like my smallest one. And this is actually a store-bought doily, one of the ones, I think, from the $1.50 bin at Michael's. So, and it's just fabric, the doily, and a, like I said, I don't have any, very many flower centers. I'm trying to figure out where you guys get these really blingy, pretty. I know I'm starting to go to thrift stores. I went today. It's been $1.50 and I got three more pieces of milk glass, so I'm enjoying it. But this was cool. I did a rolled rose with some, let me see if it's here, some lace trim that I had, this stuff. And I think I just, this was a dollar, well this is the white, but I have the off-white version too. I think AC Moore I got this, or Hobby Lobby, one of the two. So I figured them out, and then I used, this is just some, like, I think it was a lace placemat that I got for like a dollar at the thrift store, and then that's one of my doilies on the bottom, because I thought it looked a little naked. I only put five petals and then that, but that's really cute, Shabby Chic. I don't know that it's showing up in this light. And then this one's really cool. This is gold. I did the gold on the bottom. Then I did some of that like crocheted lace, and it's really fraying. And one of my doilies, and just a center. Just that's one of those buttons that you can buy, the gold buttons. So that one turned out cute. And then I did a smaller version of this one. Just skipped this layer with a small rose, rolled rose. And then this one's just like two colors of fabric and one of my crocheted doilies and a flower. So I think they turned out cute for a first try. So I'm gathering my supplies. I'm trying to figure out, like I said, I need flower centers, things like that. I'm still looking around at all you guys' videos for inspiration, and just love it. Keep it coming. Thank you all so much for inspiring, and thanks for watching.